So let's see what shows up. So if you notice, we have successfully managed to find the login page of TimeSlovenia.com. Now instead of TimeSlovenia.com, I could also type ICICIbank.com. So now I have the links to all the login pages on ICICIbank.com. So that's the beauty of Google docking. Without making the victim suspicious of what you're doing, you're simply typing some special commands into Google and you're able to identify, say, login pages or login prompts that exist on the victim domain. Another similar command is all in URL. So instead of all in title, there's a command called all in URL. So let me demonstrate that to all of you. URL. So instead of all in title, there's a command called all in URL. So instead of all in title, I type all in URL, login, and ICICIbank. So essentially here, if you look at the URL of the search results, the word login must appear in the URL. So every single search result that you have has the word login in the URL. And using the site command, we restricted our results only to the ICICIbank.com domain name. So instead of just one word, we could also enter two words. Let's see if there is something like this. So if you look at the results, now we have only one result where the words login and password appear in the URL and the site is ICICIbank.com. You can remove the site part of the command as well, and now it will show you only all kinds of domain names, but the word login and password must appear in the URL. Only then it will show up in the result. So that's another very, very useful Google Doc. The next Google Doc allows you to actually identify web cameras that normally you're not supposed to be able to access, but using Google Doc you can gain access to those. Let's see if this works or not. So I copy this Google Doc and I'm going to paste it into